Now I am going to discuss the concept of rounding off numbers. Rounding off a number means we are estimating the number which is quite close to the original number, but it is less accurate than the original number. For example, if I have to round off 73 to the nearest tens, that means we'll identify the tens position and we are to bring it to the nearest tens. That means we'll take 7 as it is, but we'll take the units digit, that is 3. Now 3 is less than 5, so the rounding off of 73 to the nearest tens will be 70, because 70 is closer to 73. Similarly, if I have a number, let us say I have 88, and I am to round it off to the nearest tens, that means I will take this 8 as the, because this is at the tens position, it will remain as it is, but I will consider this 8. As this 8 is greater than 5, that means it is closer to the next number, so I will add 1 to 8 and I get 9. So 90 is the nearest tens of 88. Or we can say that if we are rounding a number, that means we are rounding it to the nearest value of say tens. So we will take the units digit and check the value. If the value is less than 5, the tens place will remain as it is. If it is more than 5, the tens place will be increased by 1, or we can say we will add 1 to the tens place. For example, if I have a number 732 and I am rounding it to the nearest 100. Now what we will do, we will take the 100th position as it is and we will check the tens position. As I have 3 and which is less than 5, so the nearest 100 will be 700. 700 is the nearest 100 for 732. Or let us take another example. Suppose I have 975, or I can say 675, and I am rounding it to the nearest 100. What I will do, I will take the 6 as it is because it is at the 100 position. Now I check this 7. As 7 is more than 5, so I'll add 1 to 6 and the number will become 700. 700 is the nearest 100 to 675. So this is how we can find the nearest tens or nearest hundreds, or it can be any position. The next point is, if we are going to add two numbers to the, suppose we are given a question to perform addition on two numbers and rounding off to the nearest tens. That means if I have to add 73 and 47 to the nearest tens, that means I will first round off 73. It will become, as I take 7 and 3 is less than 5, so the number will remain 70 plus 47. In case of 47, the value at the 1's position is 7 and it is greater than 5, so this will become 50. Now I will add 70 and 50, it will become 120. So this is how we perform addition after rounding off. So whenever we are performing any operation, addition, subtraction, multiplication, any operation on after rounding off, first we will round off the digits and then we will perform the operations. For example, let us suppose we are having 3, 2, 5, 1 and 3, 4, 6. And I am performing subtraction. I am subtracting 346 from 3, 2, 5, 1 after rounding off to the nearest 100. For this, I will first round it off to the nearest 100. As the nearest 100 is, the value at the 100 position is 2. So next is 5. So it will be, and because 5 is equal to 5, so I'll take this number, this is 1. So this number is more than, I can say, 50. So I'll add 1 to 2. It will be 3300 minus. Now I will round off this to the nearest 100. 346 to the nearest 100 will be, as this digit is 4 and it is less than 5, so it will be 300. And then I will perform the calculations, it will be 3000. So we can see that when we round off numbers, the calculation becomes quite easy, but the result is not very accurate. So when we are in a situation when we are just estimating what the value will be, and we are not very, it is not very important to find the accurate value, rounding off method helps to solve the problems quite quickly as compared to the original numbers.